Welcome to Backyard Sports Cares. This is your host, Lisa Kaslan, and I am talking to a Backyard Sports volunteer alumni, and her name is Emily Holzberg. How you doing, Emily?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
I'm good. Should I have said alumnus? Not alumni, right? Did I get that wrong? Anyhow, Emily is a graduate of the University of Wisconsin-Madison. She also went to Mamaroneck High School, and she is now working in public relations, right?
Yeah, advertising.
Advertising for CBDO, a big firm in New York City. So we just wanted to kind of track, Emily's life, her journey thus far, and talk a little bit about what her experience is like at Backyard Sports Cares. So why don't we start with that? Tell me how you worked with Backyard Sports and what was that like?
Sure. So I started working with Backyard Sports when I was in high school, in the beginning of high school. I went to Mamaroneck High School, as we talked about, where Coach Vin, Mr. Minotti, was a teacher. Sure. And I got involved with a few girls in my grade, and we started volunteering on the Sunday sessions at SUNY Purchase. And we quickly sort of gauged each other's interest and were really excited about starting a club at our own high school. So I think that was really the biggest part of my work with Backyard Sports, was starting a club with two other girls, Paulina Peras and Sydney Farrell. And we ended up growing it to over 200 volunteers in our Facebook group, and we created our own Friday sessions with kids with disabilities in our own district at a space at a local elementary school. So we really were able to create our own community and even our own, you know, sessions with our local peers and kids in school. So that was a really awesome experience.
Wow, that was fantastic. So the club that you kicked off at Mamaroneck,
yeah.
were you actually working with special needs kids at the school, or was it more just trying to recruit other teens to kind of get involved in this effort?
Both. We led the group of volunteers, so they were our peers, and then we got to volunteer with the kids. So they were all kids in the district, their elementary school and maybe early middle school, but mostly elementary school kids, and then the volunteers were all high school students at Mamaroneck.
Wow, that's amazing. So is it still going on after you have left?
Yes, it still is going on. I know they volunteer a lot with the Sunday session. I think that's the biggest effort they do now, is send a bunch of people to the Sunday session, knowing that's also grown a ton in popularity with kids at that program. So I think that's where most of their efforts are focused, but the club still exists, which is awesome.
That's great. So how do you think that whole experience and the leadership role that you took has kind of planted seeds, so that now maybe, you know, you have made decisions that you might not have if you didn't have experience?
Sure. I mean, I think I always say the biggest thing that taught me was sort of, when you're really passionate about something, you can really do anything with it, and you can sort of use that enthusiasm and drive and excitement to turn it into whatever you'd like to. And for us, that was developing this huge club at school and really, you know, changing the culture and community at our school. I think there's a really positive force there, and that drive that the club instilled in me and the people we got to work with, I think, helped me channel that into my studies at school. And I took a bunch of classes in rehabilitation psychology and education, and it sort of shaped my volunteer experiences there. So I volunteered at a bunch of schools and a home for adults who had lived there their entire lives facing a range of disabilities. And now even at my work at BBDO, I'm actually working on Autism Speaks as one of our pro bono clients. So, you know, it's really, that work has stayed with me and always been sort of the favorite part of whatever I'm doing. So it's been really cool to sort of keep that tie and thread throughout my life.
Oh, that's a great story. I appreciate you sharing that. We love to hear that. So are you enjoying life as an adult now, and are you living on your own? What are you doing?
Yes, so I'm enjoying it. I actually just picked up the keys to my new apartment this weekend, and I'm moving in on Friday. I've been living home in Westchester, commuting into the city, but I'm, doing a little soft launch on Friday, starting to move in. But yeah, it's been great.
Oh, that is good. That is so good. Congratulations.
Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome. All right. Well, listen, we want to keep in touch with you. Please keep us in the loop with what's going on with you. And let's get together sometime.
Sounds great. I'd love to.
Thank you so much, Emily.
Thank you.